Welcome back to our GTM for beginners training. This is lesson number 4. If you missed any lessons, you can go back anytime. But in this lesson, we are actually going to take our tag plan that we have implemented last week into action and go through a tag deployment process. That's our last step. We want to deploy tags with Google Tag Manager, right? Well, all the more coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with the 4th lesson of our GTM for Beginners series. And we have already installed Google Tag Manager, we have set up a tag plan, and now we want to actually deploy a tag via Google Tag Manager and migrate our tracking that we have already on the website over to Google Tag Manager. So we will step today through the whole tag deployment process, and hopefully you'll learn a lot. You can actually test your knowledge at measureschool.com/lesson4, where we have a little bit of a quiz prepared for you. Now we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. All right, if we go over here to our Google Tag Manager account, we have already our first version deployed, but no tags are actually inside of this container. What do we want to install today? Well, that should be already in your tag plan. I have come up with an example here of a Google Analytics PageView tag that we want to deploy via Google Tag Manager. This should be our GA4 base tracking. And I have some notes here for the configurations. Where did I get this from? Well, I already have Google Analytics 4 installed on the website. So if I go to View Page Source, I should see the code. Yes, here it is, the GTag code right here. And we done a little bit of an audit of our account in the last lesson. Now that I know that Google Analytics 4 is in here, I actually want to migrate this over. So I mark this here as migration to GTM. So what are we doing next? Well, this is the configurations that we already need. This is just the little code here that we would need as the configuration. If you don't have Google Analytics 4 yet and you want to install it, then head over to analytics.google.com and open up a new account and a GA4 property. And then you will find your GA ID, your measurement ID under the setup assistant. And here we have tag installation. Then we have here our data streams, and you would need to set up a web data stream. And here we get our measurement ID. This is the ID that we want to send over in our code. All right, let's start out with the first step of our tag deployment process. Well, we actually went through the first step already. We prepared our implementation, we planned it out. Now we're actually going to implement it. This is the second step. So inside of Google Tag Manager, we can deploy our new tracking tag under the tag options, or just go here under add new tag. The first thing that I would urge you to fill out is the actual name. Now, remember, if you deploy a lot of tags, then this can get quite messy. So I would recommend that you use a naming convention to keep it consistent. So my naming convention, I already have this in here, is to say which tool it's from, what it actually does. So it deploys page view and configuration, and it will be the scope. So in our case, it would be deployed on all pages. For some people that might be a little bit excessive, but in my case, I always run really well with this because I know what the tag does just by looking at the name. The next step would be the tag configuration. When you click on this field, it gives you a lot of different tools that you can choose from. These are tag templates that let you deploy different tracking with Google Tag Manager. We obviously want to go with Google Analytics 4. This is our Google Analytics 4 configuration tag. This is the base tag that you need to install. And here you see, this is kind of like a little form, so nothing with coding or so, like we saw it in our source here. It is actually just a form and you need to fill out the right fields. In our case, it's actually pretty easy. We just need to fill out this measurement ID field where we need to put in our measurement ID that we got from Google Analytics. So we have this already prepared here. Let's port this over. And we also want to send a page view event with this tag. Next step would be to simply choose our trigger. Now, triggers are the conditions under which you want to deploy your tag. We don't have any special configurations here. We just want to deploy this on all pages that are accessible to the user. So we can go with the all pages trigger, which will deploy on any site where Google Tag Manager is installed or our Google Tag Manager container is installed. Let's save this. And now we can try it out by going into the preview mode. So you click here on the preview button and you choose your page, click start, and then your preview mode will connect to your website. we'll open it up in a new tab. And then you see this little message, debugger connected, and you should be able to now see in the tag tab that just opened that our Google Analytics view for PageView tag has fired correctly on our page. So we see inside of the tag assistant that everything is deployed fine. On our page itself, we should be sending data over to Google Analytics. So inside of Google Analytics, we have a handy tool, which is called the new debug mode. This is the debug view. And here we see that our page view is now deployed on our page and it's apparently sending data over. Let me just test this again. I'm gonna click on this new and then see if we get anything in right now. That might take a while because there's also a batching functionality within Google Analytics 4. So we might not see it right away, but hopefully in a second here. And here we go, we get user engagement. But here are our page views. And now we see that there are two page views being sent over. Why is that? Well, there is a tracking code, a tag installed in the view page source here. And also it's deploying through Google Tag Manager. So it's totally natural that we would see two page views. But we know now that our Google Analytics code is deployed through Google Tag Manager. And therefore, we can get rid of this tracking script. Now you should be doing this kind of simultaneously, but what I'm going to do right now is now that we have verified our tag deployment, we go over to Google Tag Manager and now we're going to submit this as a version to all our users. So it goes live onto our website. So I'm clicking here, submit, and we can give our version a name. I would always give a descriptor of what you have changed in this version. And then you can publish this. And that should go out now to all our users. So it's permanently installed on our website. But as I mentioned, we still have this code here on the page. So at this point, now that's being deployed through Google Tag Manager and we know that it's working correctly, we can actually go in and turn off the plugin that deploys this or get rid of the code inside of our theme files. So that's what I'm going to do here inside of our theme files. I have the global site tag here and let's delete that. Update our site. And now back on our page, I'm going to close the tag assistant actually here. So here we see that Google Tag Manager is deployed and our global site tag through Google Tag Manager. So that's not, shouldn't be in the page anymore. Let me just check here to make sure. Yep, we just have Google Tag Manager installed, or we can see only Google Tag Manager and the global site tag is deployed through GTM. Let's do another test here and actually go into our analytics. Now, actually, this debug view, we cannot use it because it only functions if we have the preview mode enabled or a connection to the tag assistant. So what I'm going to do right here is actually going over to the real-time reporting. And here we go. I'm in Berlin right now. We have one user from Berlin. That should be me, and our page views are counted. So we have Google Analytics 4 correctly installed on our website, is now deployed to all our users. And we have stepped through the whole tag implementation process from planning out our implementation to implementing it via Google Tag Manager, doing a little bit of Q&A, and then deploying it to all our users. Now, we also removed our hard-coded implementation of the G tag right here. And that's something you would need to do if you actually migrate, if you deploy completely from scratch. Then you don't have to delete any kind of codes, but it would be necessary if you are actually migrating over to Google Tag Manager. So this is now active and we can continue with the next tags in our next lesson. So there you have it. We went through a full tag deployment process with the help of Google Tag Manager. We migrated our Google Analytics 4 code into Google Tag Manager and now it is deployed through Tag Manager itself. If this all was clear and you were able to follow along, then you should be able to answer our questions at measureschool.com/lesson4, where we have a little bit of a quiz prepared for you. In the next lesson, we're actually going to dive deeper into Google Tag Manager and utilize event tracking to track interactions on our page. So I hope to see you over there. Check out this video over there if it's already available. And we also have a playlist with all of the videos of this video series right over here. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.